I'm Rick Emerson, and this is Outlook Portland on Northwest 32. We're here with Marc Acito, and when you were putting together a list of new experiences, things you hadn't done, things that made you uncomfortable, gave you a different perspective, did you canvas friends or did you go online to try to draw up this list? Did you ever get to the end of a week and say, did you make a master
constantly
list?
I had a master list that I was periodically pull from, but it's actually harder to organize than you would think because. You know, I'd have an idea for something that I'm going to, slide down a fire pole. But then you have to find a fire pole, right. And you have to look around and see where you can do that and all that. And you can't just wake up. I mean, I suppose you could. If you didn't have a job, you could wake up in the morning and say, yes, I'm going to slide down a fire pole today. And your whole day becomes about finding a fire pole. But, I actually have to work, too. And these things take time to go there and do them. And then you have to take pictures and blog about it and all that. So invariably, there were a number of days where I would wake up with no idea what I was going to do that day.
So this became like a how to eat fried worms kind of a thing, where as midnight approaches, you have to get something done.
I had some of those where it was really getting down to the wire. Weird food challenges were always a good default just in case. And believe it or not, those are some of the things that scared me the most, was having to put something strange in my mouth. I mean, as scary as it is to put a snake around your neck, for instance, to take something that I have no idea what it's going to taste like and I'm nervous about and actually willingly put it into my mouth was strange. I went to Ujamaya, the Asian food market, and we wandered around until I could find something that didn't have any English writing on it, so I could,
Total mystery.
Total mystery, and find something that looked truly disgusting, and I found this little sealed cup that looked like ancient grass clippings preserved in amber since like the Neolithic period, and opened this thing up, and here's the thing, we brought it up to the front counter, and I handed it to the checker, and she looks at me and she says, "Ooh, do you know what this is?" And I said, "No, don't tell me." And she says, "Well, even Japanese people don't eat this." And it was like vinegar noodle jello or something. I have no idea what it was, but it was the kind of thing where you, like, no number of Altoids in the world will manage to get rid of the phantom memory of this awful thing.
You can taste it still.
I can taste it still. Yeah, there's just like a little bit right in the back of my throat.
It was a sort of culinary cobra that coils within.
Right. Oh. I wish I had said it that way. That's a beautiful literary way of putting it.
Just kind of skip ahead to the end of this. This is maybe something that you have thought about or an obvious question. Are these going to be compiled into some sort of a master work, into some sort of your own calendar that you can, sort of then
foist
onto
other people? Yeah, I haven't decided yet. I'm still working on that. Now that I've got a few months' perspective on it, I'm starting to realize the effects it had on my life, and I'm just beginning to kind of put the pieces together to see what this is. Is it a book? Is it a calendar? I don't have the answer to that just yet.
But with these all transitory experiences, by which I mean there's the food, which you eat, and it's gone. There's the cobra. They put it on you. They take the cobra off. They put the cobra away. Was there anything you did that was a permanent change, something new that also then was ongoing or lasting, even for a small period of time?
What an interesting question. I think the effects have certainly been long-lasting. I look at myself differently now because of the things I did. Like, I went and learned how to walk on stilts. And, I went over to the house of the people who knew how to do it, and I walked in somebody who had never walked on stilts before, and within 15 minutes I could walk on stilts. And suddenly, it sounds ridiculous, now I can't think of myself as somebody who doesn't know how to walk on stilts, but I do find myself thinking of myself differently. And when encountering something new or frightening to me, I don't look at it the same way any longer, because I think of myself as, I was that guy who didn't know how to walk on stilts. And that was actually one of the key things I learned, is that things that seem frightening and sort of nightmare dodgeball and elementary school and inducing kind of scary, with a certain amount of information, are not. Like, I swallowed fire, which is frightening. I mean, imagine a fire coming at you that close and you're going to put it into your mouth. But believe it or not, once you get the proper instruction, it's not that complicated.
When we come back, I will have to. I really want to ask how you ate fire.
Okay.
First of all, that doesn't even seem possible. That seems like when you're like, and I consumed sunshine, and it was excellent. It's Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32. We return with Marc Acito after this.